Welcome back. I'm Carissa Kranz, and coming right out of that Oxygen special highlighting Jessica Chambers and the unspeakable, horrific crime that happened to her, which ended her life, we have an update with Cathy Russon from the actual trial herself. She's there in person covering it. Cathy, what's the latest?
Hello, Carissa. Yeah, so I'm down here in Panola County at the second Quentin Tellis trial. This morning we heard opening statements. Both were fairly short. The prosecution focused on cell records, phone records that put the Jessica and Quentin together around the time of her murder. They also pointed out that they interviewed him a couple of times and his story changed both times. The defense's opening statement was all about Eric. You know, we know from the last trial that first responders asked Jessica who did this as they were working on her, and like multiple people testified they heard her say the name Eric or Derek. So that is all that the defense concentrated on in their opening, that they need to be looking for the real killer whose name is Eric. The first witness was Jessica's mom, and she talked about how the last time she spoke to her was about 6:45 that night. Jessica was in her car driving. She thought it was odd that it was very quiet because usually there'd be music playing, and that led her to believe that someone may have been in the car with her at that time, and then she was found burning a couple hours later after that. Second witness was Keisha Williams. Keisha Meyer, Jessica's best friend. She was with Jessica and Quentin Tellis that morning driving around, hanging out. She was dropped off and was expected to get back in touch with Jessica later in the day to do something, and she never saw or talked to Jessica again. And then right before the lunch break, the prosecution put on there, this is the first new witness that was not a witness in the first trial, and it was a speech pathologist. And they put her on the stand to say that in Jessica's condition, there is no way that she could have said the name Eric. And that's where we're at.
All right, Cathy. Well, thank you so much for the update. We really appreciate the in-depth highlighting of exactly what happened today. We are keeping a close watch on this trial. It is our main trial, and it's so great to have one of our very own there really capturing the moment-to-moment breakdown that we may be missing with just the live feed, because you have the ability to see the jurors, to see the reaction in the courtroom, and to even pick up some of the interesting nuances that may happen during sidebars. So that's wonderful to have you there. I think Law&Crime is doing a great job covering this.